नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, खुश रहो बिटिया।
आई जी बी एन प्रीति सिंह, फैकल्टी ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक हैंडलिंग ऑफ रिटर्न गुड्स, रिकवर्ड मटेरियल एंड रीप्रोसेसिंग, सो कंप्लेंट एंड रिकॉल्स। कंप्लेंट्स एंड रिकॉल एंड इट्स इवेल्युएशन इज द मेन टॉपिक बिलोंग्स टू द क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस फॉर द बी फार्म सिक्स सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट्स। Now we come to the handling of return goods, recovered material and reprocessing. Return goods. Pharmaceutical products can be returned from market for various reasons. Example, quality problem, accidental damage of goods, etc. Such products when returned from the market should have the following action immediately taken on it. Physically examine the condition of the goods returned. Also check all the relevant documents. Ask quality control department to evaluate the quality of the goods received and take a decision on whether these products can be reprocessed, recovered, or need to be destroyed. If it possible to reprocess and recover, then such products after reprocess or retesting may be considered for relabeling, repacking and reselling the same. Quality control department should evaluate all aspects of the received material. Where even a slightest doubt arises about the quality of the product, it should not be considered suitable for reuse or reuse. Any action taken should be recorded. Document record SOP on handling of returns. Now we come to the recovered material. Recovered material are defined as the those material that have been diverted or removal from the solid based stream for sale, reuse or recycling. Whether or not they require subsequent separation and processing. Recovering material that would otherwise be disposed of as waste is one way to conserve resources. If done properly, it can benefit the environment, conserve raw materials and reduce energy. The addition of all part of earlier batches, confirming the required quality into a batch of same product at predefined stage of manufacture should be authorized beforehand. The recovery should be carried out in accordance with a definite procedure after evaluation of risk involved, including and possible effect on shelf life. The recovery should be recorded is very necessary, and normally 5 to 10% of recovery can be added into fresh batch. So provided the recovered material is meeting the specifications, such additions must be properly authorized and recorded. So now we come to the next step, reprocessing. Reprocessing and reuse. Rejected products batches should be reprocessed in exceptional situation, such as reprocessing should be permitted only if the reprocessed batch is going to meet the same specification after reprocessing. A detailed record of such processing should be kept. Reprocessed batches should be given by the mean of which such batches can be identified are reprocessed batches. Such batches should be separately monitored throughout their shelf life. Now we come to the complaints and handling. How to handle the complaints and what is the evaluation of complaints? Now we come to the definition of complaint. Complaints is defined as a statement that is something wrong or not good enough, which shows customer dissatisfaction about the company and the product. Example, complaint about packaging material and concerning about the product. Need for the complaint handling system. It gives the company an opportunity to improve the quality of the product. It is helpful to maintain CGMP, current good manufacturing unit, good manufacturing practices. It maintains committed relationship between the customer and company. It is the regulatory obligation. SOP, standard operating procedure on complaint handling. First one is objective, to lay out the procedure for investigation and reporting the market complaints. Responsibilities, the quality assurance manager along with the manager of the complaint related department. Procedures, complaints shall be classified in following categories to facility investigator. Product quality complaints, non-therapeutic and packaging complaints, shortage and packaging error, medical complaints, therapeutic problems. So first one is product quality complaint and packaging complaints and medical complaints. Receiving the complaints verbally, forwarding to head of quality assurance and quality control department, investigation of the complaints, report product complaint and sample action taken, etc. details. Assigning a specific PCR number, XPCR number, and recall if any. Maintenance of register of complaints. Time period for the investigation after receipt of complaint. Product quality manage, product quality complaints within 5 days, and packaging and quality complaints within 10 days, and medical complaints within 3 days. Complaints records shall be maintained at least 1 year after expiration date of medicine. Complaint record shall be reviewed and monthly summary shall be prepared for the management. Product name and complaint categories divided into two parts. First part is product name and second part is complaint category. First point in product name, batch number, manufacturing expiry date, and complaint category, packaging, product quality, medical. And next one is name, address of complaints, complaint report, all over these things. Product complaint data sheet. Product complaint data sheet should have following detail: serial number assigned to the complaint, exact nature of the complaint and name of the complaints, address of the complaint, date of the complaint, and receiving date of the complaint. If verbal, name of the person who received the complaint, and name of the product, strength and batch number of the product, reference to analytical record number. Quantity involved in the complaint, size of sample obtained from the complaint. Evaluation of the complaint by quality control department. Material and record used to perform evaluation. Other possible affected materials, product and result of their investigation. Name and signature of the investigators and date. Action taken by the company. Copy of the reply sent to the complaint. Steps in handling of complaints. The proposed handling system is in compliance with the GMP guidelines of EU, USA, and Brazil, and is presented in 4 steps. First one is receiving complaint and technical investigation, corrective action, feedback to customer, and monthly report trend analysis. Receiving complaint, it is important to have open channel with customer in order to receive their suggestion, doubt, and complaints. Generally, these channels are toll-free number, emails, chat rooms, and PO boxes. The most flexible channel are toll-free number and chat rooms. A person must be appointed in charge of receiving complaints and inputting them into appropriate investigation from that shall be addressed. The investigation form must include information about the complaints, name, address, phone number, and email, is sufficient, and information about the drug product, product name, lot number, manufacturing date, expiry date, and amount of product with the problem, and detailed description of the complaint. Customer, company's contact person, and quality assurance complaint officers is mainly is main important role in complaints. Our technical investigation. Upon receipt the investigation from the quality assurance unit is able to start the investigation. It is divided into two phases. First one is documentation based investigation, and second one is laboratory analysis. So the laboratory analysis is very important. Now we come to the there are three possible conclusions as follows: confirmed complaints, non-confirmed complaints, and counterfeit temper suspicion. Confirmed complaints, when both complaint and retained sample showed out of specification result, or when only the complaint sample showed OOS result. Example, a single unexplained failure may be when one tablet is missing in the intact blister strip in the complaint sample, but no deviation was found in the retained sample, or during the in-process control and final quality control analysis recorded in the batch process. Non-confirmed complaints, when both complaints and retained sample showed result in compliance with the specification, or when the complaint sample showed a result. Counterfeit, when the retained sample with the specification, but the complaint sample is clearly with no reason for that, such as counterfeit or tampered drug product. Now we come to the corrective action or feedback to customer. For all confirmed complaints, corrective action must be implemented. As feedback to the customer, the company must write a response letter to the complaint to explain the investigation approach taken. Now we come to the monthly reports and trend analysis. Monthly reports should be elaborated in order to evaluate the amount and the nature of the complaints received, and to perform a trend analysis to these complaints. Documentation, final product complaints report. Documentation ko kaise prepare karenge complaint ki report ke liye, so nature of the complaint, date, complaint kya hai, originator of the complaint, title, distribution, method of notification, name, phone number, date, email ID, expiry date, manufacturing date, quantity involved, everything, all are mentioned in document report. Now we come to the customer complaint record book. Customer complaint record book ko hum kaise maintain karenge? First one is a report number, first jaise dal diya. Date received, kis date ko wo complaint aapko receive hui. Next one is a product name, kaun se product pe aapko complaint aayi, us product ka naam. Received by, kisne us product ko receive kiya as a complaint, uska naam. Product lot number, kis lot se wo product pass hua tha, us lot ka number. Name is investigation is started. Investigation kab start hui thi, uska naam. Date investigation is started and date investigation ended. All our detail are mentioned in the customer complaint record book. Recalling handling. Recalling handling is also the very important part for the complaints. So this is the complete protocol for this session. And this session is powered by the digital version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. And I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it your problem by the problem resolving classes. Thank you, students, and thank you for the listening.